The leading edge slats of your aircraft are eye lift devices that will change the shape of your wing, normally by increasing the camber of your wing or the wing surface, the wing area, in order to produce an higher coefficient of lift when you're flying at low speed. Let me explain what I mean. Hi there, I'm Gabriele from pilotclimb.com. I help you to become a better pilot. So if this is what you want to do, consider subscribing to the channel. If you want to support my job, please give it a like to the video because this really helps the channel to grow. Okay, so let's talk about the leading edge slat. As we said, the leading edge slats will allow you to fly at a slower speed, okay? But why we do have them in some aircraft, okay? As we talked about in a previous video where I talked about the wing structure, the types of the wing, we know that there is not a perfect wing for every situation. When the designer are doing are creating a wing, they have to ask themselves a question. Do we need a wing that flies fast? Or do we need a wing that flies slow? Depending on the operation of the aircraft, they design the wing, okay? For an airliner jet like the Boeing 737, they actually prioritizing the high-speed wing because the cruise is the phase of the flight where you're gonna spend most of the time on an airliner and where you want to save more fuel. So the wings, the swept wings of the 737, for example, prioritize low drag and high speed, okay? But the problem is that you're gonna get the benefits in the cruise, but when you approach your landing or you're in takeoff, when you're at a low speed phase, those type of the wing will penalize you, okay? Because they won't create enough lift to fly very slow for your landing, okay? So thus, they introduce these eye lift devices, okay? The eye lift devices normally are the trailing edge flap, the landing edge flap, the landing edge slats, okay? And today, we are going to talk about the landing edge slats, okay? By extending the leading edge slats, you will increase your coefficient of lift and you will actually lower your stall speed. Thus, you will be able to fly at a slower speed. We need to understand that the leading edge slats works together with the trailing edge flaps. Okay, the trailing edge flaps is the surface of the wing that you extend at the back of the wing, and the leading edge slats are the part of the wing that you can extend in the front part of the wing. Okay, so they work very close. What does it mean? They work together. What do I mean by that is that when you extend the flaps by using the flap levers, normally you extend the trailing edge flaps and the leading edge flaps slats together. Okay, so they work together. Okay, so when you extend from flap zero to flap one, for example, you will extend the trailing edge flap and the leading edge slats as well, okay? On the Boeing 737 as well, we have a system that's called auto slats. What happened with the auto slat is that if you're approaching your stall speed or your angle of attack, you're about to stall, okay, this system will automatically extend your slat, your leading edge slats to the fully extended position in order to produce, to increase the coefficient of lift and reduce the stall speed. It's like a protection that the pilot has on board of the Boeing 737, okay? So now that you understand what is this leading edge slat and why they are important in a high speed planes, okay, let's go into the whiteboard and let me explain how does actually this leading edge slat works, okay, why the airflow doesn't disconnect from the top of the wing when extending leading edge slats. Alright guys, so as you can see from the whiteboard, okay, I'm gonna make two examples, okay, I'm gonna divide the screen in two, okay, and I'm gonna make the first example is an example with no leading edge slats available, and the second example with leading edge slats available, okay, so we will see what happens during cruise and what happens during the approach when you get closer for landing, okay, when you're approaching your runway. So during cruise, guys, this is an airfoil, okay, so this is a wing, okay, a section of a wing, so the aircraft will be something like that, okay, so try to visualize, okay, so that's the thing, okay, I'm gonna draw a leading edge airfoil during cruise and an airfoil during climb or during a slower speed, okay? Because when you fly at slower speed, your angle of attack will increase, okay? So during cruise, guys, the leading edge slats are retracted because you don't need them. During cruise, you are actually prioritizing low drag, thus you don't need the leading edge slats, okay? So once you're in cruise that you have got enough lift or during climb as well, when you have enough lift, you retract the slats. Okay, the slats plays a big role when you are slowing down or you are flying at low speed. Okay, so during cruise, the leading edge slat is retracted, so it's something like that. Okay, it's a part of the wing. Okay, so but what happened? Look at me. So during cruise, there is no problem because the airflow, okay, will go on top of the wing and on the bottom of the wing, and then will stay attached. Okay, so if you've got an airflow that is going around the wing and is staying attached, the aircraft won't stall. Okay, the problem, guys, comes when you increase your angle of attack. Okay, by increasing your angle of attack, you will see that the airflow will start to go on top of the wing, and then at a certain point will start to disconnect. Okay, because you increase your angle of attack. Okay, so we will do something like that. And as you can see, once the airflow is disconnected enough, once there is not enough wing surface that is producing lift, because this part is producing lift, but this part of the wing doesn't produce any lift, what will happen is that you're gonna stall, basically, okay? And that's the problem, and that's why we've got the leading edge slats, okay? By extending the leading edge slats, what you do, you're extending the leading edge slats, something like that, okay? Here we go. You are increasing the wing area and the camber of your wing, okay? So what will happen is that some airflow will come on here. You will create a slot that will accelerate the airflow, and we allow the airflow to stay connected to the upper part of the wing surface, okay? Thus, what will happen is that with the same angle of attack, if you extend your leading edge devices, your leading edge slat, okay, you won't stall compared to a wing that doesn't have the leading edge slat. So when you increase the angle of attack, you will reach a point where it stalls. But with the leading edge slat extended, you won't. So thus, you can increase the leading edge, you can increase the angle of attack, and you can fly at lower speed. So I hope now you understand why we have leading edge slats and for which type of aircraft the leading edge slats are designed, okay? So if you have any questions, leave a comment below and then I will help you out. Also go to pilotclimb.com where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. I wish you a great day and I'll see you on the next one.